Hey guys, this is Madhushri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I am going to be showing you how I have designed my August bullet journal spread. The book that I'm using here is a dotted book. All you actually need is this book, pen. The one that I'm using here is literally for 5 rupees, which I had got from a stationery shop. And some colors if you feel like, but bullet journal is all about keeping things simple, so you can just start with a very simple spread for your consistency and continuity. The paper quality of this journal is not very great. As you can already see from here, it's that it's a little see-through. When I was purchasing this, I didn't have much idea about what sort of paper quality I should go for. But anyhow, I know it has to be a little thick, because even if you're using a pen, it shouldn't bleed the paper. You can already see here that I have drawn the cover of the August spread. All I'm doing now is using the pen to draw on top of it. Once this is done, I will just erase the pencil sketch from the bottom. The cover is very simple. I have just used the name of the month in the middle with the calendar at the bottom. If there are any special dates, you can mention that below the calendar, and then there is just floral art around. So it's actually very simple. So the cover design is done. I'm using scale and the pen to draw the outline of the frame. And yeah, it's pretty much, that's it. This is how the cover looks like. It's very simple, and at the same time, I just like the overall vibe of it. Moving on to the goals. There are certain goals that I had kept, and there are certain trackers that I had kept for this month. So every month I have changed the trackers a bit, keeping in mind what I would want to focus for that month. You can decide your own trackers or the kind of goals that you would want to keep, but all I would just suggest that keep realistic goals, the goals that you can actually achieve in 30 days or 31 days, because it will not make sense if you keep something for the sake of it and practically it is not possible to complete it by that month. So the first page after the cover, I have decided to have the month goals, because this is very easy. The moment when you open your journal and you want to fill it for the given day, you will always flip the first page and you will always see the goals right in front of your eyes. So it's very easy for you to constantly see what you have to do or what you need to do in case sometimes it slips your mind. So that is the whole idea of why I have kept the month goals and then things that I want to do this month. Again, these two are little different. By goals, I actually meant there are certain things that I would want to achieve this month, and on the other hand, things to do are something, are certain work which I would want to get done by this month. So it could be anything. Let's just say if there is certain application that you have been meaning to send out, so you can put that. Let's say you have to get your driving license done, or you want to renew your passport. So it could actually be anything that you can put under things to do. I wanted to fill the right side of the page because I felt it was looking incomplete, and that's why I went ahead with a very simple floral design. And yeah, that is pretty much it. You can already see that this page is bleeding, so I will do something over there later, because currently it's not looking very tidy. Coming to this side of the page, it's mood tracker and sleep tracker. These are certain things which I have been tracking from the very start of the year. It helps me, first of all, track how many hours in a day I'm sleeping. Earlier my sleeping habits were very crazy, but with this tracker it has actually helped me understand how many hours in a day I'm sleeping, and the idea is actually to have a consistent sleeping pattern. So this scale depicts the number of hours, and the one at the bottom which I am filling is the number of days in a month. The hours indicate the number of hours that I'm sleeping, very simple. And the mood tracker basically will depict how my mood has been for that given month, the given day. So higher the number is how good my mood is, and lower the number is my mood not being very great. I'm just going ahead and erasing all the pencil lines. Completing this last part by drawing on top of the pencil with the pen and shading few areas, and also making sure that no pencil lines are visible, because I had already painted on top of pencil, so you will not be able to erase it once you have already painted on top of that. So this page is done. Now moving on to the habit tracker. This part is something which I really, really like. I love tracking the things that I'm doing. You can put any sort of a habit that you would want to track, be it exercise, drinking water, studying, reading. It could be anything. The other part you can see at the bottom of the habit tracker is expense tracker, and on the right hand side is workout tracker. So by habit tracker, I have already predefined the number of habits that I would want to track. On the left side, I would be putting the names, and the right hand side would be the number of days. So I am currently done with the outline, and I'm going ahead just filling the central lines, and I would be making small boxes. So each box would be equal to a given day, and that would just help me track if I had done that activity for that given day or not. So I'm writing the number of days of the month. You can see on top there are the number of days from 1st to 16th, and at the bottom it's from 17th to 31st, and I'm just shading out the last part to remove that as a number of days. And completing this page, now moving on to the to-dos list. This part is something which I use the most, because on any given day, I would want to see the things that I have to do. So I usually plan the to-dos a day in advance. It could mean anything, any important day that you want to do on that day, or anything that you want to complete. Let's just say if you're studying, you want to complete your assignment, or if there is any pending office work, and if you have to visit the bank, it could be anything. So this part is the mostly used part for me. Coming to the last part of the bullet journal for the August month, it is the food tracker. Food tracking is something which I started from last month, and it has been the most helpful spread for me. Earlier, I would eat anything or anything and would not keep a track of it. But now I actually see right in front of my eyes what I'm eating. And this has actually helped me to stop eating few things. And because when I write about it, I don't feel happy. So this has been very helpful that I end up not eating, so that when I'm writing it, I only know like I'm writing about good things which are going inside my body. So it is time for a flip through. This is how the cover looks like. It's my birthday month, so you can see I have written down my birthday. On this side of the page, I did something. I stuck a newspaper because the page was bleeding, and I wanted to make it look nice. So yeah, that's how it looks now. Mood and sleep tracker, I have already filled the first day so that you can understand how this would be getting filled throughout the month. And this is the habit tracker here. Expense tracker is mentioned, the number of subdivisions where I would be spending for the month, so all that is written here. Workout tracker and to-do looks like this. And there is something which I have added, it's called a secret project, and 1 to 10 just depicts the level I've reached on working on it. And this is the food tracker spread. So that's it. I hope you like this video. Thank you.